Good afternoon, students. Welcome to the Term 1 session. Students who have joined so far, Akshaya, Rahul, Ankit, Surya Mugam, Nandurani, Savi, Kumar Ankit, Jyoti, Mohit, Vikram, Ashit, Bhavesh, Brandon, Raj, Shivam, Shlok, Shubham, Vignesh, Vishnu, Aslesha, Mizba, Surbhi, Ankit, and few lecturers. Okay. Yeah. I will start with the usual questions. I could not conduct any cloud consultation last week. I posted it in the group also that there was no free slot. There were other faculties who were conducting it. So there was no free slot last week. This week, positively, I will take one cloud consultation for your doubt clarification. Can you just tell me what was the last topic that we covered? Can you please tell me what was the last topic that we covered? Was it JDBC? Or was it localization? Let me open your book. Concurrency thread life cycle, right? Okay. All of you know when is your exam? Yes, Akshaya, Rahul, Vishnu, Surya Mugam, Shivam, correct. You have to study Java 7 Standard Edition Student Guide. Java 7 AC Student Guide. Total, I think 15 chapters are there, all chapters. Wait, I'll tell you the name. Introduction will be your first chapter will be on JVM, JRE, JDK, those concepts that we discussed in the beginning. Second chapter is classes, class design. Third chapter is encapsulation. Fourth and fifth is advanced class design. So all the access specifiers and modifiers, all those keywords. Then you have inheritance with interface. Then you have generic selections, chapter 8 string processing, chapter 9 exceptions, chapter 10 Java IO, chapter 11 Java NIO, chapter 12 threading, chapter 13 concurrency, chapter 14 JDBC, which we are going to start today, and chapter 15 is localization. All 15 chapters will come for your exam. Okay? All of you are studying from book because everything will come within the syllabus of the book. Nothing will come outside the book. There are few self-studies also, that's why I'm telling you. You have 12 more days to go for your exam, including today. 12 more days to go for your exam. So from today itself, if you start the revision, if you revise, if you go through at least one chapter every day today, from today, first five chapters will be very easy. So let me tell you, if you start with second chapter, first chapter is JVM JRE, that you can go through from my notes also, you may not go through from the book. But from second chapter onwards till the 12th chapter, so total 11 chapters you have. 11 chapters in your syllabus. So from today, if you start revising, just go through line by line every chapter one day. So today you revise chapter 2, tomorrow you revise chapter 3, day after tomorrow you revise chapter 4. Like that, every day revise every chapter. And revision does not mean only the topic. Revision means read line by line. Why? One thing, because they might give you multiple choice question, match the following and fill in the blanks. So if they are giving match the following and fill in the blanks, obviously you have to go line by line. I'm not saying they will pick out the line from the book, but they will give you the sentences from some paragraph. They will reconstruct the sentence, but they will give it some paragraph which is there in the book. So go through everything. Okay, diagrams, obviously whatever I have given, you can refer to that diagram. But the paragraphs which are written, especially the notes, you will see after every topic, below there's a little note, some hint or some important points are given in the notes. They give you fill in the blanks of 1 mark from those notes also. If you revise one chapter every day, you'll be done. Okay? Chapter 8, chapter 9, chapter 8 onwards in fact, chapter 8 onwards, questions will be very difficult. Chapter 8 onwards, questions will be very difficult. Okay? Jyoti, you give me your ID password. I will show it to you online. Your book. I will show your book online. You give me your ID password here. Yeah, Jyoti, don't type anything else. Hold on, don't type anything else. Can you see the screen, Jyoti? Now you can type, Jyoti. Can you see the screen? Cloud Courseware Library, Java Standard Edition 7. One is Lab Guide, one is Student Guide, one is Activity. Ideally, you were supposed to do the Lab Guide and Activity during your MR. So I'm hoping that all of you have done that. For your revision, open this book. See, 15 chapters are there. This is not required. Appendix is not required. Chapter 1 is JVM, JRE, JDK, which you can learn from my notes also. You may not go through the book. But from chapter 2 till chapter 15, you have to go through the book line by line. So starting from today, if you revise only one chapter one day, your work is done. Your work is done. Okay? I'm not asking you to memorize. But if you have attended all my classes and if you have done on the practicals, then this revision will make everything register in your brain permanently. Because this will be a second time. First time you have attended the class where I have explained the topic, I have shown you demonstrations to make you understand with the concept. And then you have practiced the same concept during MR. So when you go for the revision, you go through the chapter anyway, you will understand and it will be a recapitulation for all of you. Is that okay, Jyoti? Books and chapters. Books and chapters clear. Anything else, Jyoti? I will sign out. Or before signing out, let me show the exam date also. I think you can see the last cycle test that you have will be on 8th of March, and after that exam on Saturday, Java exam on Saturday. After this your term 2 will start. Okay, anybody has any further questions? So what was your cycle test this month? February, you had a cycle test on 3rd on 16th, and you had a 10 PM on 13th. So all of you have given all your cycle tests so far in the month of February. You have given 2 cycle tests and 1 PMR. All of you. Term Jyoti is CERM. Term 2, I will teach, probably yes, but I cannot guarantee. Signing out. Okay. So, today we are going to start off with the concept of JDBC. Full form of JDBC is Java Database Connectivity. Now, before I start explaining it, let me ask all of you that what do you know about database? What is your concept about database? Have you ever come across this term database? What does it mean to you, database? Yeah, this is correct. Rahul correct, Shubham, Vignesh, Aslesha correct, Akshaya very correct, Surbhi correct, guess to Rohini Center, you are correct. But not to the definition. I asked, what do you mean by database? What you said is, or what you said are, the few operations or the few tasks we can perform in the database. Yes, Chavi, you are correct. So, majority of you are giving the correct answer that database is a software or a software program which helps us to store the data or store huge collection of data in a very organized fashion. Okay? Otherwise, I can store a data in Notepad also. Like, let's say, for example, if you go to a village, you will see that there are shops in villages also. You will see there are shops, stationery shops, grocery shops, medicine shops. You have shops. And they also keep a record they also keep a record. So they keep a record in the register. They have a manual handwritten register where they will keep a record. Record of both things. I mean, if you say that yes, it is keeping a record of the medicine as well as the customers, then they will have two register books. One register book will have the details that on which date, which are the products that have come to the store, and against that product, how much was paid, which supplier supplied it, how much is due, that register. Another register will have the details, every customer name, transaction ID, customer phone number or whatever, address, and against that customer, what was the product the customer had first purchased and the amount. But this cannot be possible in modern industry. You have terabytes of data getting generated every year. You have MBs of data, megabytes of data getting generated every day, every week. So obviously it's not possible manually to keep a track of all the data. So we need a very strong software. Okay? So that's why these database softwares were created, with the help of which we can store data in it. Okay? But database software cannot understand human language. Okay? Just like for developing a software, we are using Core Java language. Similarly, for storing the data in a database, we have to use a database language, which is called Structured Query Language, SQL. Why is this SQL used? So that writing this SQL language, we will be able to send the data or store the data inside the database, or fetch the data from the database, or update the data, insert new data, modify data, delete existing data. So we can do all kind of operations on the data using this language called SQL. But when you as a consumer, when you as the end user is using any software application, let's say you're using Facebook, let's say you're using Zomato, let's say you're using Ola, okay, any app, any application, anything that you're using, ultimately it is generating a data, but you don't store the data. Let's say you have used Ola, you have used the Ola app to book a cab, okay? So somewhere in the Ola database, a transaction ID is created, a customer name is given, and against that transaction ID, that against customer, against that transaction ID, there is a customer ID, there is a date, there is a description like source and destination of the travel, driver, cab driver name, cab number, cab driver's phone number, customer's phone number, bill, I mean the fare that was charged for that ride, okay, and if there's any discount or not, every details you will not find, but you are just clicking one book button on the Ola tab app. You're just touching an option called book or request or cancel, something like that. But against that click, some data is getting saved in the Ola server, which is probably in Bangalore or Chennai or Mysore or somewhere. So how is that happening? Any idea? How is that happening? I mean, it cannot be magic. I mean, sitting in Uttar Pradesh, you are booking an Ola cab and the data is going and getting saved in the server database of Chennai. Okay. Yeah, Shivam, correct. Partially, but at least you are on the track. Shivam, Rahul, Rahul, correct, but then, Rahul from Korbangla, you're correct, but then, my question is, how the data from your front end, from that Ola app is going to the server? Because I told you, in order to save our data in the database server, in the database software, we have to use SQL language. We have to type SQL language. But when you are clicking on OK or book or cancel, you are not typing any SQL queries. Yeah, Vignesh, you are correct that user will input the data. How will the data go? Yes, Ashlesha, correct. Yes, exactly, Ashlesha. This is exactly what I was looking for. Let me see if somebody else also guesses it. Only the front end interacts with the end user. Only the front end. Sorry. No, Asha, there's no technique to convert the language into database language. No, there's no such technique as it, at least till date, there's no such. Script is saved on the button. Yes, correct, Shubham. Script is saved on the button. So this script is including what? Not exactly. What about the rest? Cannot play students not answering. Pridya students not answering. Guest students, Borivali not answering. Majority of Borivali students are not answering. Vashi, Pune Karadi. Yes, sort of, Shubham. When you click on that Ola app, when you click on that book or book my cab or when you click on cancel or whatever, against that button, the SQL queries and the database connectivity language is written. Yeah, definitely to some extent DAO will work. Yes, Vignesh. No, there's nothing, there's no language which is converted into anything. There's no conversion into the picture. There is a mechanism to simply connect. There is no mechanism of conversion. So not exactly DAO process. Without DAO also you can connect. Without DAO. DAO means when you have a proper model class, when you have interface, when you have implementation. You may not have interface, you may not have implementation. You can have a direct button and the moment you click on the button, the data goes and gets saved in the database. That's it. You may not have the interface or anything. So that is done through a bridge called database connectivity. Okay? That means there's a mechanism to connect your front end. The front end or the front page or the front application with which the end user is interacting, that page will connect with the back end database. Okay, so that database connectivity is a technology which has to be implemented in this scenario. Now when you are connecting this database can either be in your own machine, okay? Or this database can be in Chennai and your application could be in the browser. So anybody across the globe, whoever is using your browser, using your application through browser, will be clicking on that same button, but ultimately the data will go to the server in Chennai or Bangalore. Okay? So database connectivity means the front end will connect with the back end database. This front end and back end connectivity can be in the same machine also. Let's say in the same machine you have the Ola app and the database is also in the same machine. Both are installed in the same machine. The front end is created in Java, back end is created in Oracle, both are there in the same machine. Could be possible, very much possible, but the technique that you use to connect the front end and the back end will be same, whether it is in the same machine or is in a different machine. If it is in the same machine, you give the URL part of the same machine database. If it is in a different machine, server machine, which is remote, which is in a different geographical location, then you give the URL of that different machine. That's it. otherwise the technique will be different. So this connectivity between your front end and the back end varies, okay, depending on the platform, not exactly platform, depending on the environment that you're using. If you're working with front end of Java, you will write the connectivity with JDBC. If you're creating the front end in .NET, you will create the database connectivity with ADO.NET. If you are creating the front end with any open source, okay, PHP or Python or anything, any open source language, you will create the connectivity with OLEDB or ODBC, Open Database Connectivity, okay, anything. So there are multiple technologies in the market. With the help of which we can connect the front end with the back end. I'll explain it with the diagram which will come in here. These are the text boxes, these are the OK buttons, cancel buttons, okay? It has some URL, okay? So this is your content, or we can also call it view. Interact okay. And then you have the you have a text box here as name, you have text box as city, and then you have a text box as age, okay? Same structure of tables will be there inside the database. Columns. One user is using this, entering a data, one row will be inserted. Again, another user is entering a data. The first user is, let's say, Ria. Second, somebody from China is using it. Okay. Both are using the same browser, multiple instances of the same software. URL will be same for both the users. But this instance and that instance will be different. Two objects are created. Every user will use every object. So when each user is entering the data, each object is holding the reference and storing the data. By now, I think all of you know how object carries the data. You have learned it in stream reader and writer, in file IO. You have learned it in serialization, that how object carries the data. So every page instance is an object. That object is going to hold these data. So they are all parameters of that object. Okay? But the question is, how will the data come from here? This page is created in a JSP or .html, and this is created in, let's say, Oracle database. Okay? JSP or HTML or .java, whatever. Okay? This is the fun. Ideally, it is JSP and HTML. But we will practice with Java because this will come in your account Java. So there is a bridge. One bridge that takes the data from front end to back end. Another bridge that takes the data from back end to front end. Right? Both of this is handled by you have to re-log in, Nandurani. I will try. Can we autofocus the whiteboard? Students are not able to see it properly. Is it okay now? So this bridge connectivity is JDBC. It will send the data as well as send the data to database, receive the data from database. Okay, both are requests and responses. Let me tell you, when a user is entering the data and clicking on OK, that is also a request. User is requesting the software to send the data to the database. So when the user clicks on OK, the request is sent to the server, database server, and database server responds it by taking the data and storing the data. And then on a new page, the user is trying to fetch the data and see the details. Then also user will click on view or click on any button, and again that button click will be a request for the database, and database will respond by giving that data on the page. Is it clear, all of you? What is JDBC and how it is used? What is the back-end engineering of JDBC? Is it clear? Okay. Now we see what are the major APIs of JDBC. What are APIs? What are APIs? Yes, Rahul is correct. Application programming interface. Okay. So you have a class called, I'm giving the name of the API. Driver manager class. Okay. What is this used for? Of the database. See, if you insert a 10 drive in your machine for the first time, what does it show in the notification area? For the first time, let's say you have bought a brand new laptop and you are inserting a mouse USB or pen drive USB in the USB port for the first time. What will it show? Very good, Shubham. Anybody else? Yes, Akshaya, Ashit, correct. Yes. It will show that driver is installing or USB driver is installing or driver for new device is installing. First it will say new device found and then it will say installing driver, installing new device, installing new driver for device like that. Okay, that means whenever you want to use that USB port, before using it, you have to use a driver. That driver will read the data through the USB. Whenever you are inserting a CD drive, let's say you have added a CD-ROM in your CPU machine system. Okay? After that, if you insert any DVD or CD, it will not run. First, you have to install the driver software of that CD-ROM. Then only it will be able to read the data from the CD. So similarly, before connecting to any database, you have to first install or you have to first configure or invoke the driver manager method, which will initiate the connection or which will be referring to that connection object of the database. So this is the first reference of the database. Second, connection class. These are classes. Driver manager is a class. Connection is a class. What will connection class do? So next is connection. This is used to obtain a reference to the statement object. Okay? And the method that you use is statement method. Okay? So what is this statement? it is nothing but that SQL syntax. Okay, so SQL syntax has to be written inside that connection. So first you have to consider the connection object. Connection object will refer to the statement. We will come to statement later. So connection object will not directly hold the SQL. Connection object will refer to statement. Statement object will call create statement. And create statement will have SQL syntax. Okay? Take this page and I'm going to write the next one also. Take down this page and write done. So, third is statement class. These are names of classes. These are methods, whichever has brackets. Okay? So statement object is used to obtain the reference of the result set class through an execute query. Okay? Inside the execute query, you are going to have the SQL. Have the SQL syntax. Okay. Or you can use, you also have SQL, or you can use any of these three methods with the help of result set object to execute the query, and that query reference will be put into create statement of statement class. That statement class object will be put into reference of connection object. That will be again referred by driver method. Is the sequence clear? All of you? Yes, Aklesha, I will take you on air. Shlesha, can you ping me? I'm not able to find. I got it. Vashi, Shlesha. Yes, Shlesha is connected to you. Please tell me. Shlesha. Adjust your camera properly and unmute yourself. Focus towards the wall, I guess. Shlesha from Vashi. Can we call up Vashi? I am able to see only the wall, Shlesha. At least say something. Unmute your mic and say something, Shlesha.
Hello, ma'am.
Shlesha.
Can you hear me, ma'am?
What is wrong with Vashi? Wait, I'll take somebody else from Vashi. I'll take Mizbah. Mizbah from Vashi. Mizbah. Same issue. Surbhi from Vashi. Surbhi. Can you please get a place in your seat? Hi, Shlesha. Am I audible, Shlesha?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yes, tell me, you have a doubt in driver manager? Louder. I'm not able to hear you. Hold your microphone closer to your mouth.
I don't understand you.
Driver manager? Driver manager? What I said, I don't know. But anyway, driver manager is a class. Okay? Or you can also call it as a class interface. This interface is used to create the JDBC connection, okay? And these are predefined interfaces. That's why they are called application programming interfaces. They are all predefined. So connection, driver manager, statement, result set, all these are predefined interfaces and classes, right? Out of that, when you are writing the JDBC code, the first object that you have to create will be a driver manager class. Driver manager class object has to be created first, okay? Because that object will be able to connect you to the connection class. Connection class object will be able to connect to the statement class. Statement class object will be able to connect you to the actual method, which has the exact SQL syntax. And ultimately this SQL syntax has to be fired in the database, it has to be executed in the database, right? So this is how the flow will go. I think you have lost Vashi. Very poor infra in Vashi. Extremely poor infra in Vashi. At least if you can hear me, Surbhi, Mizbah, Shlesha, confirm me over the raise hand if you have understood. So Mizbah, have you understood? I will explain more with a demo of your database, okay? Give me the camera. Imran, give me the camera. Okay. Let me show you something which you will anyway learn in the next semester, but the next term. But then it will be easier for you to understand if I show you now. I have installed the Oracle database in this machine, okay? I am going to turn on the Oracle database right now. This EXP software helps me to connect with the Oracle database. This SQL developer, this one which I am running, this will help me to connect with the database, or rather interact with the database. Everybody can see the screen. So this Oracle SQL Developer database is getting created. Getting opened. Okay, now I will connect to a specific database. I will give the password, because database is critical, it stores the company data. So ideally nobody, any employee, anybody who is not a valid employee of the company, there is not a proper ID password, should not be allowed. So every database will open only with a proper ID and password. Okay, I've entered inside the database. You can create new tables, you can create new data. Your database connection has been reset, any pending transaction or session has been lost. Okay, not a problem. Okay, so now let's say I want to open the table that has the details of my employees. I want to see the list of names and address, phone number, designation, department ID, everything about my employees, all employees of my company. This is a fictitious database. So I cannot write like this, now dear database, please show me the data. It will not understand. So I have to use a language which it will understand, which is SQL. That is structured query language. Okay? And in the structured query language, you have a language called SQL, DML, DDL and DCL. DQL stands for Data Query Language. Text data from database, data manipulation language, sort, update or delete data in database. DB is the short form of database. DL is data definition language. This is not SQL, I'm writing it in plain simple English to explain. This is not a syntax. Data definition language to create, alter or drop DB objects like tables and views, and DCL is data control language to grant or revoke permission. Okay, so out of this, DQL use the syntax select. Okay, so let's say there's a table called employees and I want to see all the data of employees. So I will write select star from employees. Star means all the columns. This is a syntax. This one I will select, go to this green button and execute. Showing me all the data of the database. You can see if I scroll, can you see I'm scrolling, it's showing all the data. Yes, no, some say something. Are you able to understand what is database, how it is working, what is SQL? Yes or no? Only 4 or 5 students are responding. Okay. Now, do you remember the methods I showed you for result set? Open that page where you have taken down the notes, the last page. What are the three methods of result set that we can use to execute the SQL queries? What are the three methods? Akshaya, correct. Rahul, correct. Rahul from Kormanga, correct. No, Ashit, I said methods of result set, not statements. What are the methods of result set? Aslesha, correct. Ashit, now you are correct. Shubham, I am asking what are the methods of result set class that we use to execute that query. I have just given you, na, in the whiteboard. Got it, Shubham from Borivari. So we have the three methods of result set: execute, execute query, and execute update. No, not statement. Execute, execute query, and execute update. So whenever we are executing any DQL, we use execute query. Whenever we are executing any DDL, DML, we use execute update, and for everything else we use execute. Okay, No, Chavi. No. You are not getting my question. My question is, what are the methods of resolution? Okay, so this is how the database works. Now, same thing, let us see in Java. This is a separate database, Oracle. NetBeans has some inbuilt database also. So, I'll show you that. Can you see this portion? This I will turn off my screen. Open services. Just wait, it's a little bit slow. The services, there's database, expand that database. Can you see these are broken? Can you see these connections? These are broken. So we have Derby database, which is inbuilt, but it is broken. Yeah, it is broken. So what will we do? We will right click and connect with the database. Password is APP. I will ask it to remember the password and click on OK. So it is connecting to the database. As I told you, every database will have ID password. In Oracle, we were using HR. Here we are using IAPAP. So now it is showing me the databases tables. See, just like Oracle, instead of employees we have customer table. You right click and view the data, you will be able to see a similar table. Select star from app.customer, fetch first 100 rows. Showing you the data. Star means it is showing all the columns. Instead of star, if you give specific columns that show me only customer ID and name. Showing you only two results, two columns, customer ID and name. Can you see? It's no more showing multiple rows. Yes, no more say something. Only 5 students responded, 6 students. If you have doubt, please tell me. If you do not have doubt, please tell me clear so far. It is clear so far. Okay. Now our job, this is the data inside database. It has got no connection with Java. It has got no connection with Java. But I want a Java program to display this database data. So what do? I create a new project, Java application. Next, this database name is Derby. So let's create Derby example. Now the packages, very important, predefined packages, because you see JDBC is a complicated code, but we don't write so much, no? We just write driver manager connection, create statement, result set and execute query. That's it. We don't write much, so that means majorly we have to import all the things. So we have to import java.sql.driverManager. Okay. Then import java.sql. You just have to import all the packages in any sequence, you can do that. java.sql.sql exception in case there is an error. Import java.sql. dot statement. Okay. Move unnecessary lines. We will not make any class or anything here. We will directly write inside the JDBC, main method. So we will take few variables. String variable, URL, string variable, username, string variable, password, and string variable query. Any idea? What we will store in URL, what we will store in username, password, query, maybe you will not be able to say because we don't know SQL syntax. Any idea? Akshaya correct. Akshaya correct. Can all of you see that this Derby database has a URL? Yes, Rahul correct. Can all of you see that this Derby database has a URL, the one that we connected to? That database has a URL, can everybody see? That is how it will connect, no? That is what I was explaining you when I was explaining Ola. That Ola front end will connect with the back end database with the help of URL. If the URL is within the same machine, it will work. If the URL is in a different server, that will also work. So what you do is, wait, my mouse got, my screen got hanged. Just wait for 1 minute. Okay. So I will copy this. Don't rename it. I just click on rename so that I can copy it. So we copy this URL and put it in this. My username is app, password is app, and query is select star from customer table. Okay? It was customer, right? Or customer, customer, okay. Okay. Now what do we do? First thing, we have to create try. Okay? Inside the try, we will create the object of connection class, which will hold the reference of driver manager. Dot get connection. We'll use the third method, third overloaded method. So machine is going a little slow. So first I will pass URL, then I will pass username, and then I will pass password. Okay? Clear? First line. Second, cannot find symbol. Oh, I have not taken connection. Sorry. Import java.sql.connection. Okay. Now, next is statement class, statement object equals to, it will have the reference of con connection object, create statement, okay. Right now I am not passing any value in create statement because I will be using execute query. So create statement will just create a statement, but what will be the query of the statement, that will be decided later. Next will be result set. Sorry, there will be semicolon. Result set object equals to statement object dot. Can you see we have execute query, execute update, execute only. Apart from that, you also have large update and batch. That is not, I mean, at your level, you will not be using it. Majorly, we use execute query, execute and execute update. Okay? So, I'm going to execute here, execute query. and instead, and what will be the parameter of this execute query? Can anybody tell me? What will be the parameter of this execute query? Yes, Ashish, very correct. Nandurani, correct. So this parameter will have the SQL syntax. So right now, have I written any SQL syntax? No, not try body. Try body will come in second bracket. Within the first bracket of execute query, what will I give? Have I written any SQL syntax so far? Yes, Akshaya, correct. I have written the SQL query and saved it in the query variable. Instead of query, I can also name it Q or anything, ABC. Okay, anything. Details, whatever. Anything. So I have to pass that variable here. Okay? Always remember with try, you have to go for catch. And this catch will have SQL exception. SQL exception is what? Checked exception or unchecked exception? I've taught you. SQL exception is what? Checked exception or unchecked? Tell me. Yes, Ashlesha, correct. Nandurani, correct. Yeah, thank you, Shubham. Yes, it is checked exception. Okay. So, we have created the connection with getConnection method and we have passed the URL, username and password. So, getConnection will do what? GetConnection will connect to this URL and open the connection using this username and password and store that reference in con. Okay. Con will create the statement and store the statement reference in STMT. STMT will execute the SQL syntax and store it in the result set. So that means after this line, after line number 18, the RS object will have the entire table in it. RS object will refer the entire table because I have selected the star. Which means select star from customer, that means I have selected the entire table. So now entire table result is there in RS object, okay? But I don't want to see all of them. I just want to see, let's say the first three columns, okay? So I'll give a while loop in the body of the try. Okay? And in the while loop, I will give while RS dot next method has a value. Okay? Always remember result set object acts as a cursor to navigate to the So from first row to second row, second row to third row, this will act as a cursor. So as long as there are rows, it will keep on going to the next. And as long as it will go to the next, it will display the result. But this result will not be a normal output of Java like you get. This will not be a normal sentence or some variable output. So you have to store the data in a variable and then give the output. So you will create three variables. String. First three columns was what? ID. Second column was what was second column? Discount code. Second column was discount code. Chal gado. Discount and string text. The first variable, every time the first variable will take the first column value. Result set object dot get string column 1. Second result set object dot get string column 2. Actually column 1 is column 0. And third one is rf dot get string column 3. Okay. Now, let me right click. So one thing I forgot, in the libraries, see the Derby library jar file is not added. So what I have to do in the library, I have to right click. Because see, I am doing the minimum amount of code. The majority of the code is already done and saved in the jar files and packages. So I have to add the library, or I can add the jar file, anything. So inside, inside C drive program files, inside C drive program files, there will be a folder called Java. Inside that there will be JDK, inside that there will be bin. Sorry, JRE. There will be library. We will directly take it from database only. From DB. Don't take it from library, you have to again search a lot of things. So directly take it from DB. right click, jar, inside the library, inside the DB there will be a library, there choose Derby client, Derby net, okay, and add it, add the three jar files, okay. Now you run this program. Database sample app on app was not found. Oh, sorry, sample. Database name is sample. SAMPL. So now we have to display system dot out dot println id plus state plus response space plus name, okay. So we are getting the data here. If you notice, these three are the columns of the table. This is a different software, this is a different software. I am connecting, I am bringing the data from this database table and displaying it on the Java console by writing this JDBC code. Is that okay? Is this okay? All of you? Is it clear how we are doing it? What is JDBC? How we are connecting? What is happening? Anybody has any query, please ask. I will share this code also, so don't worry, I will upload this in your group, so not a problem. Jar files are Java archive files, which means code files are library files which are already written to support the Derby database. To support, instead of Derby, if I would have connected to other database, then I would have taken other jar. Like, I would have added anything else, like I would have added Oracle jar files. Oracle jar files you will not directly get in DB. You have to download and save it in this library file. Since Derby is inbuilt, that's why you got the library files directly. Otherwise, you have to download and do it. Otherwise, how will it read the Derby? This is the actual engineering which has been done and coding has been saved in jar files, na? Kanchan, is it clear? Kanchan? Let's have the end of session questions. So we are over with JDBC. We are only left with one chapter, which we will complete on Thursday. After that, coming week, we can dedicate to doubt clearing. After that, coming week, we will dedicate it to doubt clearing. Okay? And don't worry about this example. I don't think you'll be able to take it because it has the jar files and everything. So, you'll not be able to take it like that. If you have taken a snap, very good. But apart from that, I will upload this. In fact, I will upload it right now. And you can check also. Please answer the question on your screen. Anything else which I have to upload, please tell me now. I will upload at a time. Anything else which I have to upload? I think I have uploaded NIO and all those. Concurrency, I am uploading the notepad where I have pasted the code. I am not uploading as a project because in the notepad you also have the explanation. So concurrency and JDBC. Concurrency and JDBC, I have just uploaded. Please check and tell me. Concurrency and JDBC, I have uploaded. Concurrency is in Notepad, JDBC is as the project. Because JDBC, this project hierarchy will not come. It is not possible to give it in Notepad. Okay. However, you can take a snap of this. This will help you to refer. Just take a snap of this. You will remember that this is the database, this is the Derby database, this is the URL, you are putting it here in the code, and this is your project. In the project, you have a separate folder for Java coding, separate folder for database jar files. Taken? I don't know, Ashlesha, maybe you do not have Silverlight installed. Others can get the files. It is a zip file. You need to have zip don't try it. If it is not happening, don't try it from this machine. Try it from your home PC. You know, NIT might have some security block. I don't know. I'm not sure. That should not be the case, but then you can try it later also. But what I'm trying to say is, you must have that silver light to download it. And you must have that zip software to unzip it. Or any other unzipping software, okay? Your next class will be Thursday. Anything else you want to say? I hope all of you are going through the cycle test schedule. So that's it from my side. Please do the practice. Yes, Ashit, cycle test 6 is the last cycle test. I think it is there in your schedule also, Ashit. So please check. Please check. I don't remember it right now. I think it is, but in order to be absolutely sure, check it from the schedule. It's on 8th of March. Okay? So thank you, everyone. We'll meet again on Thursday. We can end the session.